I'm Lucia Grillo with Italics. We're at Manhattan Hotspot RSVP, where Hamptons magazine is celebrating its July issue featuring Mira Sorvino. Tonight's celebration is also on behalf of Union Square, a new film by Nancy Savoca. You've made a number of films now, from True Love to Household Saints and now Union Square, that portray both a humorous side and an almost darker, uncomfortably familiar aspect of intimate Italian-American family life and culture that really not many filmmakers have offered to us in their perspective. How do you tap into that, and how do you do it without succumbing to stereotypes?
I think that the things that draw me to these stories are more emotional autobiography than autobiographical. I think that I love to explore our faults, our weaknesses. Our strengths come out naturally, but our faults and our weaknesses are the things that we all of us struggle to hide. And I think that intrigues me. The things that are hidden intrigue me. So I think if you're looking for those truisms in people, you're not going to fall into stereotype, because you're going to look for something that's very specific and true. So that's where I like to go.
And tell us about how it feels to premiere your film here in New York.
Great, great, exciting. I love the fact that we've got our cast is in town and we're celebrating together, and they did such a good job for us, and I'm so proud of everyone that worked on this movie, and this is a great night for us to show our appreciation and our gratitude, really, because the movie, there's not a single person that worked on this movie that if you take them away, the movie would not be what it is.
That leads me to my next question is, this is not the first time you work with Patti LuPone.
Oh, I'm so excited. Patti is someone that I've always wanted to work with again, because she's so super talented, and she does, she's a very larger than life, even in person. She's a big person, personality, but when you give her these delicate things to deal with, she does, people think that she just does the big stuff, but she does beautiful, subtle things. It's in her singing, it's in her performance on stage, and she brings it on film, and it's really exciting to watch it too. So I'm thrilled to be working with her again. Anytime with Patti, anytime. We hope that everybody comes to see the movie on July 13th when it opens in New York, and wherever it's near you, just check us out online. Thank you so much.
Tell us how you approach this Italian-American character, Jenny, and how passing is, which is one of the themes in the film, is still relevant today.
Oh, I think that I wanted to do the film because I felt like this was the opportunity for me to possibly encourage and inspire people that haven't talked to their family in a long time, that are estranged from the people that they love, to watch the film and pick up the phone after and call that long-lost relative. Because family is everything, and that's the feeling that I got from the film. Jenny, my character, I really can't watch her too much, because it's like watching myself go through this really hard experience where she's just very uptight, and she's abandoned everyone that she loved in life and created this whole new life and left her family behind, and that's just not the person that I am. I'm very loyal and I love my family. Yes, they're crazy, but I would never want to spend more than a week without seeing my brothers and my mother and my nephews and nieces. So I felt like it was an important film to make.
She, are you Italian?
I'm Italian-American, yeah.
I'm mezzo.
Mezzo, tell us how how it was for you to portray this character that's dealing with so many Italian-American issues.
Well, you know, the big reveal in this movie was when Nancy met me. She thought, oh, I found this great, solid, all-American guy. And then after we finished filming the movie, I said, well, I got a little secret. I'm like, my family's from the Bronx. I'm half Italian, so... So I know these personalities, but for the character, I kind of had to pretend as if this were, you know, some huge tornado that I'm subjected to. So it was a balance of being familiar with it and then also being really surprised by it, because Mira Sorvino is just a force of nature in this film, and it's you know, for anyone, even for someone who's Italian, to be around that is just kind of. It triggers a lot.
This film is a universal film. Like, if you've loved Nancy Savoca for years, this one is like, to me, it's like her crowning achievement, because anyone who is a child of a parent and a sibling of someone or has somebody in their family that they can't get along with but they still love at the bottom, this film touches everybody, men, women, everybody, because it's very deep, but it's also very funny. And that's the beauty of it.
Can you tell us a little bit about your preparation, homage to Anna Magnani?
Yes, well, Nancy asked me to look at Amore, the Roberto Rossellini movie. It's like a half-hour movie that Anna Magnani did, where she's on the phone breaking up with her lover in a very beautiful way. And I said, Nancy, I always hesitate to watch other people's performances to influence mine. And she said, well, think of it as though you're watching your mother, that these are like the women in your family. I don't want you to be like her. I just want you to see what your life would have been like with these women. And then my character is much more rowdy and crazy and extreme. But we have a very similar scene in the beginning of our movie where I am breaking up with a lover on the phone in the middle of a very public place rather than in a beautiful, quiet apartment. And of course, I'm not as beautiful as Anna Magnani or as iconic. She's so iconic and still and lovely. And my character is like losing her mind in public. But it was very interesting because there were real passersby watching me have that breakdown in the park. And they would like come up to me and ask me if I was okay. And it was so interesting that in New York City, people could actually care that someone was crying and losing it. You know.
This is not the first Italian-American role you've played. You played one in Tarantella,
yes.
Diana in Summer of Sam,
yes.
And now this character.
And even in Sweet Nothing, Gary Winnick's film with Michael Imperioli, we were Italian in that too. So, yes.
And you managed to do it without going to the cliche. How do you manage to avoid that and to bring about such a beautiful, original, and unique performance?
Well, I am Italian American. I'm only half. My mother is very white bread Americana, but I guess I never want to make us seem like a cliche. I pick upon, you know, the things that are endemic to Italian Americans. They're often kind of loud and kind of boisterous and full of life. But within that, to have a real beating soul and a real sensitive heart, rather than just being a hollow shell of somebody who's, oh yeah, yeah, Benny, you know, come over here, yeah. You know, because that's just exterior, it's not the interior. So as long as you fill it up with love and hopes and dashed dreams and wishes, then she's a person and she could be from China or Russia. And the fact that she's Italian is good because it gives her characteristics, but her soul is a unique person.
You had some experience behind the camera in this film.
Yes, I actually shoot the little video segment with Patti LuPone. And Patti's Italian too. and I tried to make it look even messier than I could make it because I wanted it to look very like amateurish. But it was fun because I was supposed to be the voice behind the camera, so I said, why don't I actually do it? I'll do the interview with her and then she'll really be relating to me rather than me standing next to the camera person. You know?
So is there a future for you behind the camera?
I don't know, but let me tell you this. My husband, Christopher Backus, is now directing a film in Las Vegas called The Sessionist, which is being produced by Italian producers. Yes, so you'll probably see us next year in Italy with the film at the Italian film festivals.
Well, I'm glad to hear it. We look forward to seeing that as well. Okay, thanks so much.
Thank you.